Hello friends, welcome to the investment banking module of Wall Street Mojo. Today's topic is capitalization ratio. And friends, as you all know that every ratio plays a very important role in the financial analysis of any particular company. Capitalization ratio is one of the most important ratio when we are deciding on the investment strategy of a particular company. And unlike other ratios, capitalization ratio itself can be divided into three parts. Basically, capitalization ratio helps to evaluate how much portion of the company's debt is invested into the business operations. That means, out of the total capital of the company, how much is the portion of debt the company has? And therefore, the capitalization ratio can be divided into three parts. Let us try to first understand what are the three different capitalization ratio that we have been talking about. The capitalization ratio formula can be understood in three different parts or three different formulas. What are they? Number one, debt to equity ratio. Number two, long-term debt to capitalization ratio. And number three, total debt to capitalization ratio. And friends, while each of these three formulas or each of these three ratios holds a different importance in the ratio analysis, but all the three can be classified as capitalization ratio. Why? Because each of these three formula basically helps to evaluate the proportion of debt to the total capital of the company. Let us try to understand first what capitalization ratio means. Capitalization ratio is primary tells us how the company is using the debt as part of its financing strategy. We have already discussed about it. Basically, using capitalization ratio, we are able to identify how much debt the company is using and its total financial portion or total investment in the company. Let us try to understand very briefly what each of these three capitalization ratio helps us understand. Let us start our discussion with debt to equity ratio. What does debt to equity ratio means? Debt to equity ratio is nothing but total debt divided by shareholders' equity. As you all know, that the capital of the company can be from two sources. One, equity, and the other sources is debt. Debt equity ratio basically helps us identify how much portion of my total capital is debt. For example, if I'm saying a debt to equity ratio of a particular company is 2.5:1, or if I'm saying the debt equity ratio of a company is 2.5, what does it mean? It means for every dollar of equity invested in the company has $2.5 of debt. Let us try to understand this with the help of an example. Suppose the debt of a company is $500,000 and equity of the same company is, say, $750,000. In that case, what will be my debt to equity ratio? My debt to equity ratio will be $500,000 divided by $750,000. That means 0.67 will be my debt to equity ratio. And what it indicates? It indicates for every $1 of equity invested in the company, the total amount of debt which is invested in the company will be $0.67. Let us try to compute it. Suppose in this case, my equity was $750,000. And when I'm saying, the debt to equity ratio indicates how much debt will be invested in the company for every dollar of equity invested. So when I'm multiplying $750,000 with the debt to equity ratio, it should give me $500,000. Clear? Now, this is about the debt to equity ratio. It helps us understand the capital structure of the company. The second ratio is long-term debt to capitalization ratio. Friends, the debt can be also divided into two parts, short-term debt and long-term debt. Short-term debt are those external borrowings which the company takes to meet the short-term obligations of the company, usually for a period of less than 1 year. And long-term debt is the debt which the company takes to meet its long-term liabilities or meet to fund its long-term business requirement, which is usually more than a year. That means the repayment schedule of those debts are usually more than a year. Long-term debt to capitalization ratio holds importance in a sense that if I want to identify that out of my total capital or total capital which is invested in the company, how much is my long-term debt? That is very important because the repayment schedule of short-term debt will be in a year. And therefore, we need to understand what is the portion of long-term debt in my total capital. Okay? Capitalization ratio means long-term debt to capitalization ratio means long-term debt divided by capitalization. And what does capitalization here means? Capitalization here means long-term debt and the shareholders' equity. That is called as capitalization. So basically, this ratio means long-term debt divided by long-term debt plus shareholders' equity. Please note, we are not considering short-term debt over here. Clear? Now, moving on to the third and the last capitalization ratio, which is total debt to capitalization. This is no different than the second ratio which we discussed. The only difference is here we are talking about total debt. That means we are talking about both short-term debt as well as long-term debt. So the numerator will be total debt, that means short-term debt plus long-term debt, and the denominator will be long-term debt plus short-term debt plus shareholder equity. Here the definition of capitalization is long-term debt plus short-term debt plus shareholders' equity. Friends, we have understood about the formula. Let us try to understand with the help of a practical example. As you can see over here, this is a chart of a company debt to equity ratio. And what you can see, the debt to equity ratio of the company has increased significantly over the last 8 to 10 years. And currently, the debt to equity ratio of the company is 2.792. What does this indicate? This indicates that for every dollar of equity which is invested in the company has a debt of $2.792. Okay, so this helps us understand how much leveraged or how much debt levered the company is. How much is the portion of debt in the company's total capital? Thank you.